All right, guys, let's watch sports with the final NFL let's watch of the 2016-17 season. Obviously, Super Bowl 51 is today. And I know I gotta be biased, I know, but I still believe my pick for this one is the Pats. I'm gonna say, score-wise, it's hard to tell, man. Sometimes you think you can get a score right, and sometimes no. I really think this one will be like, let's say 28 New England, and I'm going to say 21 Atlanta, something like that, around there, touchdown difference. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoy this. I'll see you all at the end. Mike, not working.
Out comes Matt Ryan, getting ready to lead this team in the Super Bowl, and he'll also learn, Charles, the night before the big game if he takes home the league MVP award. So a lot going on for Matty Ice.
There is, and you and I both know that if we asked Matt about that, the first thing he would say is, I'm not concerned about the MVP stuff. I'm only worried about the Super Bowl. But that's just being a little bit disingenuous. You can't help but be involved with an award that says you're the best of the best in your sport. If Matt Ryan were able to win that one, I think it'd be an extra bounce for him going into the Super Bowl, where I think he'll perform very well.
Here's Ryan, and it's hauled in by Austin Hooper. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
A fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 9. They run the play fake to Coleman. Now Ryan. And it's complete. Hooper. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catchability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. And speaking of Devontae Freeman, Charles, curious how the Patriots are going to handle he and Tevin Coleman. They've been such a good 1-2 punch this year. We know the Patriots have a good D. How do you see that battle going down?
I sense that Atlanta's going to try and get the Patriots linebackers on the move, because they are thumping type guys on that side of the ball. And if you're Atlanta and you use Coleman and Freeman, get them out into space, make those guys chase a little bit and try and cover them, that'll be an interesting matchup. But what I like about Devontae Freeman, the passion that he plays with, and that sets a tone for his offense. He'll just have to make sure that he's not overamped for the game and force some errors.
They run Devontae Freeman. And down inside the 15 he goes. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
That's another nice run, and I have to tell you, some of the coaches that I played for, their philosophies were always different when they see a guy running the ball well. Some of them wanted to immediately go to play action and throw it now because it's wide open. Well, other coaches said, you know something? Until they stop him, that big boy's going to keep getting the football. And that might be the direction that they're going to go right now.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. From the red zone now, here's Ryan on first down. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. It's a 4-yard pickup, and it'll make it second down. And a man, as we look at the starters now, a man who really has earned us talking about him in the booth, Julio Jones.
He's a 1,000-yard receiver each and every year. So sleek, so wonderful. I call him Secretariat.
Second down, Freeman. He pushes forward for maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line. And you get a look at the defense. It was the top scoring defense in the entire NFL. They look pretty good against Pittsburgh. They'll be playing in another Super Bowl. How do they do it? Because they don't have household names at every position.
And that's a great point and a great question, because when you go out and talk to the average fan, name 10 guys, name 5 guys in the New England defense, they're often hard-pressed to do it. But picking up Kyle Van Noy midseason and turning him into a cover guy and doing a nice job, and he punched one free in the AFC Championship game. And take a look at Alan Branch holding down the middle against the Pittsburgh run defense. They may not be household names, but they know how to coach them up, and they know how to plug them into the right.
And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And now the rookie's free. The 40, 30. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. Now a first carry for LeGarrette Blount. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. When you look at X factors in the Super Bowl, LeGarrette Blount, he could be one. Now the question, how will they use him? Divisional round, not many carries. And then he did get a lot of carries leading into the Super Bowl. So we'll see how they handle it.
Atlanta's defense is built on speed. Look at the linebacker position. They are run, chase, hit guys. The secondary, speedy, can cover. The test for them is, can they handle a heavy running game? That's why I think LeGarrette Blount is a bigger factor in the Super Bowl than he was against the Pittsburgh Steelers. I think they're going to want to control the game with their running game, and Blount will be a key factor, much more so than Deion Lewis and James White catching passes out of the backfield.
Well, we know Brady relies so much on Julian Edelman, about 10 targets per game this year, but Chris Hogan obviously came to life against the Steelers. Well, he did before that, but he can have an impact too in this Super Bowl.
He certainly can, and that's the beauty of Tom Brady playing quarterback. If you find your way open, he will find you. So I think Chris Hogan could have an impact on the game. Martellus Bennett at tight end could have an impact. Danny Amendola from the slot position could have an impact. And, of course, throwing to the backs, James White and Deion Lewis. So, Tom Brady, if you're open, he will definitely find you. Offense.
So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. It'll be a pickup of 13 on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
That's a good strong run there. While it won't pick up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
From the four, it's second and goal. They'll run again with Blunt. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going to play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
Brady now on third and goal. Finding time. That's caught at the two. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Koski now for the Pats field goal try. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. Now it's scooped up, and this is a live football.
So the next time we leave one of those coaches' meetings and we're walking out in the hall and you're like, how come we spend so much time talking about special teams?
Here you go. This is why.
This is why, right? And then look, I'm right there with you. We hear it every time we meet with coaches. But it is a big part of it. Look at how early in the game this occurs. They block a kick, and not only does it set a tone, it sends a message for the rest of the game.
Yeah, so much for our first points of the game. And not great starting field position here for the offense. The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. No gain on the play there. Second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle. That's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
On second down, Ryan. He completes it to Julio Jones. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. Well, it's no secret the defenses have pretty much not been able to cover Julio Jones this season. How do the Patriots do it? I know that that's the $64,000 question. What's the answer?
I think they do it in a variety of ways. I think it's going to be a combination plate that they'll throw at him. Sometimes you'll see Malcolm Butler, the number one corner, go ahead and line up with Julio Jones. There'll be times where he won't, and they'll end up double-teaming Julio. But whoever's on that side will show him different things. They'll come up and press him. They'll back away. They'll pretend to press. They'll run with him. They'll wait at 5 yards and catch him and then try and jam him there. So many different things. Anything trying to chip away at his timing.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
And that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold him to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
Second down following the run. Freeman again, and not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with third and five.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First-level defensive line, second-level linebackers, third-level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first-level run, and it was stopped by a second-level player. An extra corner on the field for New England here on third down.
Yeah, another DB. Here's Ryan. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Chris Long able to drop it for a loss of 12, and it'll be fourth down.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big. But sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz. And even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
On fourth down, here's Matt Bosher on the punt. Back deep, Danny Amendola for New England. That's taken on the 25. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. And the Patriots coming onto the field led by Tom Brady, getting set for his seventh Super Bowl appearance. Now, his counterpart, Matt Ryan, this will be his first. That's obviously a storyline. Is it overhyped, Charles?
I think it's probably overhyped, but I still think it's significant because Tom Brady doesn't have to do any guessing. He has a routine for the Super Bowl that he's been able to follow six times previously. This is the first time for Matt Ryan, so everything's new, and he's kind of guessing along the way. Am I putting in enough time here? Is this the right thing to do? Is this the wrong thing to do? Tom Brady has none of those worries.
One recent example, Peyton Manning defeated by Russell Wilson. That was a 43-8 game. Now, Manning hadn't been to seven Super Bowls, but that's one recent example.
Yeah, and that's why I call it an advantage, because of the seven Super Bowls. I think when it's two, three Super Bowls, not nearly the same advantage, because you're working out your process along the way. Seven times, your process is down.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They fake the handoff. Now Brady. Over the middle, the catch made by Mitchell. And he's going to get this inside the 30. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks, because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. So one quarter down here in Super Bowl 51. Nothing our score. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number two. They've got a second and nine to start things out. Throw on second down. Screen pass to Blunt. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. It's a loss of four. Now third down. And that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there, because trying is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this case, when you realize that it's broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the ball tipped up in the air, and you come back and try and pick up the first down on third down. That way you don't lose any yardage.
Here's Brady. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. And the kick is good. the crossbar, but the carom goes his way. And the Patriots jump out to a 3-0 lead. So not the strongest of kicks we've seen him make, but he gets a favorable bounce, and it's 3 points all the same.
Yeah, that was one of those where he needed the 6-iron, but he pulled out the 9-iron. That one was run out of gas quickly, but he does manage to pop it over the bar.
Goskowski now converted for three. Now he'll kick this one away. This is taken at his 4. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And before the Falcons take over on offense, a stat that is definitely worth mentioning. They have scored this year 540 points, tied for 8th all-time in league history. But my question to you, if you had to pick one key for this offense to be successful against New England, what do you think that would be?
Offensive line. And I know that's not a very sexy thing to talk about, but the rebuild of the Falcons' offensive line over the last 2 to 3 seasons has put them in a position to where they are in a Super Bowl, because that offensive line allows all that great talent at the skill positions absolutely flourish. The front office and the head coach, a tremendous collaboration of rebuilding that roster.
He's got time. Pass incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver.
Brandon, Super Bowl 33 saw Atlanta take on Denver, and they were led, of course, by John Elway at quarterback. Here we are now with Super Bowl 51, and Atlanta back in the Super Bowl. This time, they get Tom Brady. They don't catch a break at the quarterback position, do they?
Couple Hall of Famers. Yeah, it's not going to be easy. That last one was in Miami. This time, of course, in Houston. We'll see if they have better luck this go-around.
Well, the one thing Atlanta has in their favor this time, probably the league MVP and their own quarterback, Matt Ryan.
Just a couple there on the second down run. Now they're staring at a 3rd-and-8 situation.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
They run the play fake to Coleman. Now Ryan. And it's complete. Hooper. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. They come out here in the eye. Now Ryan on first down. The left side completion to Jones. 15 yards through the air on the first down.
In man coverage, your number one cardinal rule, don't get beat deep. And that's why the comeback route is so effective, because that's how they're selling it, Brandon, taking you all the way upfield before breaking it back down.
And 10, it's Ryan. And this is Gabriel on the catch. A gain of 6 there on first.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Handoff. It's Freeman. Oh, he shifts past him. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
False start. Offense.
Come on, oh, come on, oh.
Still third down.
The 22 is the line to gain here on third down. On third down, Ryan. And this is going to be incomplete. They were looking that time to get it to Justin Hardy. And it's fourth down. So a field goal try here on fourth down as the Falcons call on Matt Bryant. It'll be a 47-yard attempt from the left hash. And the 14-year trusty veteran able to knock it through, and that will tie us at 3-3. So this offensive unit, they've now had three drives, and they only have 3 points to show for it.
Payoff is the key for everything. How many offenses have we talked to that say we have to finish drives? Thus far, this team hasn't finished it quite the way they wanted to.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. Now Deion Lewis to return. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And the Patriots getting ready to go again on offense. And Charles, you and I get a stat pack before every game. At the top of this one for the Patriots, the first note was that they're on their way to their 9th Super Bowl appearance. That is something. Most of any team.
And 8 of those since 2001. Would that be accurate?
That
because
is accurate.
The first one was Super Bowl 20. That didn't go very well against the Bears. But since that time, they've become the predominant team going to Super Bowls and winning them. What a franchise.
Throwing on first down is Brady. To the right side, it's caught by Mitchell. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Brady, and complete on the right side to Bennett. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Charles, so many of the Patriots know what the Super Bowl feels like. Martellus Bennett, a guy, 8th year, first Super Bowl trip, and after the game, you could tell he was a little elated, doing some dances with the cheerleaders. And
The pom-poms were going everywhere, weren't they?
They were.
But the interesting part was his observation later on social media, where he said, I was out of my mind excited. I looked around at a lot of the guys on the Patriots team, and they're like, yeah, you know, we've done this before. Okay? We can be cool about it. But think about his impact this year. Supposed to team with Rob Gronkowski, became the featured tight end after Gronk's injury. They are so glad that they picked him up. When you got a big guy like that in your backfield who runs as a big man and breaks tackles, it is paramount for a defense to have extra defenders in his vicinity at all times. Because you got to figure he's going to break through the first guy. You're going to need tacklers 2, 3, 4 in order to get him down. Because if you don't, he can continue to run and run it really, really well.
So it'll be first down here after the run. Now a play fake here on first down. Over the middle, the catch made by Mitchell. And down inside the 15 he goes.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Into the red zone, it's Brady. And this is caught, it's Edelman. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Well, if you like to see guys play the game hard, if you like to see the guys be aggressive, if you like to see the guys maximize their ability, you're talking about Julian Edelman, aren't you? Yeah. What a game he had in the AFC Championship against Pittsburgh.
118 yards and a touchdown, and now he'll look to do what he did in Super Bowl 49, where he was over 100 with a score as well.
And he's just one of those guys that if he's on the field, you have to respect his talent, but you especially respect his passion.
Now Brady throwing on second down, and he can't corral it. Maybe a big missed opportunity there defensively in the end zone, and now third down.
Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
Defense showing blitz. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Brady to throw on 3rd and 1. Oh, it's a touchdown if he holds on. Instead, it's 4th down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
So on 4th down, Brady will yield to Gostkowski for the field goal try. And remember, he had one blocked earlier. And Gostkowski's kick is good. And they will take the lead here in this battle of field goals at 6-3. So this time the protection holds up for him just fine, and he's able to bang it through.
I think their special teams coach got the point across. He gave him a pretty good earful after the block earlier, and this time there's no penetration, so they're able to pick up 3.
Gostkowski now converted for 3. Now he'll kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll be brought down at the 23. Make it the 24-yard line. A chance for us to get a glance at this Patriots defense. A field goal last time is what they gave up. In a close game, all these drives start to feel so critical.
And they are. And, you know, we've met so many defensive coordinators who just really hate the bend but don't break mentality. They're much more of the aggressive school. But that mentality has won a lot of games. If you're only giving up field goals on drives, that usually keeps you in it and gives your offense a chance to retaliate.
Yeah, and right now it's got them with the lead. They'll run with Freeman here to begin the drive. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
A 1-yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Again, they'll run with Freeman, and he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Only a gain of a couple there. That leaves him needing about 7 here on 3rd down.
The best defensive lineman They play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
On third down, Ryan. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. This is taken at the 18. 12 yards on the return that time. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Patriots offense, they worked their way back out onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Here on first down, and no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front, nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
To play here in the first half. We're back to Super Bowl 51 after this. A reminder coming up at the intermission, we'll get highlights of this Super Bowl from Larry Ridley and the crew in Orlando with our EA Sports halftime report. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Brady to throw on second down. And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here, he throws it away. And now it's third.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude. But I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. So on fourth down, the left-footed Ryan Allen to kick it away for the Pats. Back deep for the Falcons is Eric Weems. This is taken around the 12. A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And let's shift now to talking about the Patriots' defense. They have a little something to build off of from last time with a three and out.
And what they have to build off of? Great confidence right now. Being able to stuff someone on a three and out, you feel like you're in control now. You're doing the dictating. They want to see if that can continue as this game progresses.
Will it continue? We'll see. Throwing now, Ryan on first down. This one complete to Mohamed Sanu. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. And they're going to speed things up here. On second down, here's Ryan. He goes underneath to Freeman. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. We'll give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. He's got time in the pocket. And he's got some space here. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Give him 16 on the pickup. And that leads to an Atlanta first down. On first down, Ryan surveying the field. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. Second down, throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Austin Hooper, the tight end, was the intended target, and it's third and short. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. Ryan now to throw on third down. And that's incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. On the left hash, officially, it's called a 51-yard attempt. And the kick for the 41-year-old is up and good. And that will tie things up as we head toward halftime. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This one fielded at the 5. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Tight end's a blue. first and 10. Here's Brady. And complete on the right side to Bennett. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. Now Brady throwing on second down, finding time, and caught. This is Bennett, the tight end. And 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up in the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
Brady now on first down. He's got time. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Really good job by the offense there. Every second counts right now. So for them to get out of bounds and save some time, that's a nice move.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Throwing on first down is Brady. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. Give him 8 on the play, and that'll make this a second down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. And we are back here. I'm Brandon Gunn alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes a timeout. And now we're set to get going. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Again, it's Brady to the left side and complete for Julian Edelman. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone.
Offense.
So holding by the offense and maybe now got to shift up what you want to do on the playbook.
Yeah, definitely. Change what you're doing in the playbook, but boy, the advantage shifts to the guys on defense, doesn't it? Longer yardage situations, they often become bolder.
Brady to throw again. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. Throwing is Brady on third down. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. So on fourth down, Brady will yield to Gostkowski for the field goal try. And remember, he had one blocked earlier. And we will likely not see another play here as they take the knee and head into the intermission all tied. So we've reached halftime in a low-scoring 51st Super Bowl from Houston. As we send you over to our headquarters in Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley for our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Thanks, Brandon. I'm Larry Ridley, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. Let's look back now at this closely contested first half. So we've got a tie game at half, and you can bet both coaches are in that locker room making adjustments and telling their guys to just keep playing hard like they did in the first half. All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Falcons have it later on the drive. Hooper is able to haul in the contested pass, and the play will come to an end after a gain of 40. Hit to late in the first. They're going to come away with another sack. This ends up as a huge loss in yardage. First and 10, with plenty of pressure this half and another sack. This will go for a loss of 7. So that'll do it from here in Orlando. The second half of Super Bowl 51 still to come, as we rejoin Brandon and Charles in Houston.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. Danny Amendola on the return. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Falcons set to get things rolling on defense again here. We are all even on the scoreboard, so I guess sort of just a blank slate as we start the third.
You just exhale at the half and start over. Come out with some excitement and try and set the tone with your defense.
Now flags come in. Looked like one of the Patriots might have moved.
False start, offense. Still first down.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Shotgun now for Brady. He's going to sling this deep downfield. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Ricardo Allen with a pick. And they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
So we get set to start this third quarter. Here's the Falcons offense now. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. Third quarter starts with a run by Freeman. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here. It's second and 12. On second down, Ryan. It's caught over the middle, Hooper. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
Well, they get the completed pass, but still have more to go here on third down. Ryan now to throw on third down. And that is incomplete. Pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
This is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. Their defense did its job, yielded no points. Now it's the offense's turn.
And how much fun is that when you set things up to start a half and you just tell you guys, hey, if you can shut them down, get it back for our offense, we can roll. And they played out perfectly. Now, can the offense do what they wanted to do at the half, which is find those weaknesses and now attack them and score some points.
And break this tie. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They start on the ground here with Blunt. And he'll lose yardage here. Back to the 15. It's a loss of five there, bringing up second.
Whenever I go to a team's practice facility and watch them work, I love to watch the defensive guys in what they call pursuit drills. The ball goes either towards them or away from them. How fast will they respond? On this play, the defensive end responded better than anyone and made a really nice play.
So the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's second and long. Blunt, the lone running back. Now a play fake, Brady. And his throw here is incomplete. Malcolm Mitchell out of the University of Georgia was the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down.
Well, sometimes you just have to take things into your own hands, don't you? I mean, the offense is really struggling in this game. They're the ones keeping things going. They have to continue to play at that level.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. On third and long, it's Brady. And he comes back with one complete. And he's eventually brought down, but not before he reaches the 39, just shy of the 40.
That coach is always hard on the quarterback reading the defense and getting into the open man. That's That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, but when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. On first down, Brady. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking for Julian Edelman that time. And that'll bring up second down.
Okay, Brandon, before we break this game down any farther, I've got to talk about Tom Brady. He's going for his fifth Super Bowl title. I think Bradshaw has four, right? Montana has four. Brady wants to be the only quarterback with five Super Bowl titles.
Won his first one back in 2002, trying to get number five in 2017. You think if he gets it, that he puts all the rings on at the same time?
For a definite photo shoot that'll go up in New England everywhere, no doubt about it.
No, I mean out in public just for fun.
Hey, why not? Hey, he'd be Tom Brady with five Super Bowl championships, the first and only quarterback at that time.
Offense trying to avoid stalling out, facing a third and 10. Again, they'll throw with Brady. Going underneath for Lewis. And he's brought down, but following a pretty juke move that gives him the first down. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. On play action, it's Brady. And he's going to be sacked back on his side of the field at the 44. Tyson Jackson, he's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. In a play like that, with how far he had to go to make that sack, shows how athletic defensive ends have become in the NFL.
And not just athletic. This is coached in a big way. Run to the football at all times. How about him never giving up on it and pursuing all the way across the field?
Ninth play of the drive now on third and a country mile. They fake the handoff. Now Brady. It's brought in by Floyd. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They go play action here on first down. He's got time in the pocket. Still back there. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. LeGarrette Blount was the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
That's just flat out a terrific play, because it's rare that you see a hitch route batted down. That means someone read that one really well and was right on the spot when the ball got to the receiver.
Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense.
Like 20!
And he gives now to Bull. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that's going to lead to a third and 11.
And that was a nice play by the defense. And it is tough to be an offensive lineman nowadays, especially if you're dealing with how the defensive tackles have evolved. Their quickness, their agility, their speed has changed the big guys in the middle, the center, and the offensive guards. Formerly, they were just power players. Now they have to be light on their feet as well to keep up with the speed of the defensive players. Third and 11, five in the secondary now.
Nickel. Throwing is Brady on third down. And this is going to be incomplete. James White, the man he was looking for out of the backfield. And now it's fourth down. So on fourth down, Brady will yield to Gostkowski for the field goal try. And remember, he had one blocked earlier. It's blocked. It's picked up. A live ball here, remember.
We've been in enough practices, and how many times have we stood on the sidelines and a unit goes out to kick a field goal and hear a special teams coach say, make sure you protect. First thing, protect. Especially, and here they give up a block.
Yeah, especially in a tight game like this, tied second half, this is what execution is so key.
They go over everything in the huddle. The last thing you're going to hear everywhere, make sure you protect. That didn't get done.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll try to get the ground game going with Freeman. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
And they still need 8 yards for the first here on second down. Now Ryan on second down. And finding the tight end Hooper. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Third down now following the completed pass. Ryan now to throw on third down. Finding Gabriel complete. The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
And now a first down following that long gain. Now a play fake here on first down. Surveying the field. Going up top. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. The counter, Devontae Freeman. And some space here. And Freeman lost the football. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
And heading back out there now, the Falcons defense here. And the last time, remember, they forced a field goal try, and it was no good, so it was a big win for them.
A huge win for them, because anytime you have an empty possession or you force one, you feel great going off the field, and probably a little chatter towards the kicker, like, hey, nice miss, my man. Let's see if that affects him the rest of the game.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. The drive starts with a handoff to Boomz. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
All right, partner, despite my eating habits, I'm not big enough to play offensive tackle, nor am I quick enough. But with the defensive ends nowadays and their speed, those guys have to be able to punch and dance, and it's a tough, tough job to contain them.
Defense in a good spot. Let's see how the offense responds with a second and 13 now. Again, here's Blunt, and he'll get across the 20, but only to about the 22-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and they've got it back to third and 10.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on third. Now a play fake. Brady finding time. All kinds of time. He's got a man. It's Mitchell. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there? Yeah. Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
Fresh set of downs here. First and 10, here's Brady. Over the middle, that's caught by Hogan. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
Second down now after the pass completion. One quarter remains in Super Bowl 51. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. And the offense still has a couple plays to go to pick up the first on second down and 3. Brady to throw on second down. To the right side, and he's got Edelman. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
So here we go, first and 10 now. Blunt, the lone running back. He's going to get the football. And a solid run down inside the 30. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and two.
This drive is turning into an extended one. And the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
They fake the handoff. Now Brady. Caught. Left side. Bennett. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there? Freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Here's Blunt. Trucks through him.
Oh, man.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. LeGarrette Blunt, 22 yards. And the Pats able to cash in for 6.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet or they just executed better. Because they had 2 previous drives that ended in field goals. Before this one, they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, whatever he did, speaking of the offensive coordinator, might be using that formula going forward. It worked there.
Yeah, it works very well. He and his field general in pretty good sync right now. They're starting to move the ball well.
And it's up and good to extend the lead to 13-6. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And it ends in a touchdown run by LeGarrette Blunt. Goskowski now, after the touchdown, he'll send this one away. Here's Eric Weems now on the return. Oh, look at that.
Oh, look at him turn.
And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Heading back onto the field, here's a look at Devontae Freeman now. He is fully awake now. If he didn't get off to the start that he normally does, they've got his attention. He's running it well.
You think they set off the alarm clock at the half? Think that's what went down? I know this, having played on the defensive side of the ball, if you do a really good job against a great runner and you go into the half, you're excited, you're fired up, you think the game plan is working, but in the back of your head is that little bit of nagging doubt. Can we do this for 4 quarters? So far, that's not happening.
They go play action here on first down. He's got time. He's going to wind up and air it out. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Devin McCourty picks it off. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line.
Brandon, offensively, this has been a tough day for him. Trying to find a place to throw the football. It's been extremely difficult. I've got to give a lot of credit to the secondary, especially the corners who've had the receivers on lockdown.
So the Patriots coming out now. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. Forward for a couple down inside the 40. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Second down, 8. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Now Brady throwing on second down. And over the middle to the tight end, Bennett. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. He can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer. Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. On second down, here's Brady. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Vic Beasley in there to get him for his second sack of the night.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Yeah, they've got an extra defensive back out there now on 3rd and 13. Now Brady. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Grady Jarrett, he's the one to get him this time. And back-to-back sacks are going to bring up a fourth down.
I remember when I was a kid and all I wanted was a nickel so I could get that soda down at the fountain. And guess what? The nickel came into play well. 5 defensive backs, they covered well, allowed for the sacks.
Sodas were a nickel when you were a kid?
No, I just needed the extra nickel so I could pay the proper price.
Okay, how much were they? A dime? What were they?
15 cents.
Here's Ryan Allen now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. And this will be out of bounds, and they spotted it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time, one play interception, so this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Wide open receiver complete. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. Throwing now, Ryan on first down. He's got time in the pocket. He's going to float this one deep right side. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
I like the boldness, and I like that they took a shot downfield, but it was well covered, and he's able to get a hand in and knock it away.
So second and 10 here. Second and 10 now, Ryan. He's going to let it go again. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Can you believe it? It's a Super Bowl 49 hero, Malcolm Butler. Agreed, that's twice now in this fourth quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
And now out come the Patriots. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Begin here with Blunt. And some room to work. They get 25 yards out of that one. And it'll give the Patriots a first down.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick. He's been decisive. And he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
So the offense has it first and 10. Play fake here on first down. And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there, second down.
Whenever I see an in route dropped, as we just saw on that play, I'm always thinking that in the back of their mind, they're worried about what's coming at them because they're going towards traffic on that route as opposed to being away from it and maybe having a little bit more space.
Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. He'll run it here with Blunt. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. They get six here after the incompletion, and it'll leave them with a third and four. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
It's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Here's Brady. This is caught. It's Julian Edelman. Call it a gain of 10, and they pick up the first.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
That's so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Now the offense lining up first and 10. Now a carry for Blunt. He's able to work free for about six down to the 18.
I know that every now and then we get in those meetings with coaches and you almost want to roll your eyes when they talk about staying on schedule when they're moving the football. But would you say a 7-yard run is ahead of schedule?
Fourth quarter with the lead, you love that, don't you?
No doubt about it, because staying on schedule is trying to get four downs on first down. They did that plus three.
And the offense here just looking to stay in bounds, complete the short passes, and put this game on ice. Brady. Brady gives this one to Lewis. Oh, what a move. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. Time for a break. We're back to perhaps crown a champion after this. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. They've got it first and goal as they search for what could be a game-sealing touchdown. Brady. That's caught at the 3. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. Second and goal. They'll go to Blunt. Try and pound it in. And the Falcons going to use another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. So they held him out on second down, and now here's third and goal. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the 2. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a 2-score game. Kowski's kick is good, and that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. So that's a big one there. It's his 3rd field goal of the game, and a 2-score lead's got to feel pretty good right about now.
And while they're not free and clear yet, you're right. Now this defense can go out knowing that it's going to take more than one big play to catch them.
Kowski now converted for 3. Now he'll kick this one away. Here's Weems to return. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The D for the Pats. The Patriots heading back onto the field now. They're just looking for one final stop here, put a capper on this affair.
get this game over with. That's all they're talking about. It's that simple. Finish this thing off, and let's get to the locker room and celebrate.
Celebration, that's what they're hoping to do soon, but still a little work to do. Ryan. And finding the tight end Hooper. And he makes it all the way down to the 31. It's a big play there for Atlanta. 43 yards. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Here's Ryan. And Jones has it over the middle. That throw good for four. It's second down. Ryan surveying the field, and he'll take this into the end zone. Now hold on here, we do have a flag down, so let's see what this is about.
Holding offense.
So a little grabbing there, but this time it goes against the offense for holding. Obviously a tough spot here. They need a lot of luck to win this game, but still a small chance.
They've got to make sure they get the ball to the sidelines, get out of bounds, preserve clock.
Ryan to throw. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. Now it's Ryan. And the catch is made by Justin Hardy. If they're going to have a shot in this Super Bowl, they're going to need this one on fourth down. Here we go. It's Ryan on fourth down. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about slim and none? Well, Slim just left town on that
They're
one.
They're down to none?
Yes, exactly right.
The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. Getting down to the end here, they have a two-score lead. Barely, but it's a two-score lead, so that probably makes you as a coach feel a lot more comfortable right now, doesn't it, Charles?
It does, but it doesn't mean now you go out and run option or some kind of wild double reverse or anything like that. But you do know that if anything does go haywire, you're still in control of this game.
I want a double reverse, don't you?
I'm just waiting for that day where we actually see something like that in this situation.
We'll see what happens here.
Alright guys, so apparently it's going to be a really low scoring game for my simulation. A 16-6 Super Bowl 51 victory for the Patriots. That was score wise, I didn't expect at all, no touchdowns from Atlanta. I was surprised. But yeah, that's the end of the game right there. Hope you all enjoyed. I'm going to keep the Super Bowl celebration going. But that's it for me, guys. Good luck to Atlanta and New England. I'll see you all in the next one. Peace out.
That's just got to be absolutely amazing. That, the task, incredible. But the accomplishment, forever.
Hey. And they are the Super Bowl champs. The Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. And what a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.